Good morning, Redbeck Noodle School, and welcome to RB Soul, where we are continuing to celebrate greatness. I am very pleased to have Miss Harris here as my guest this morning. Hey, Miss Harris.
Good morning, Miss Graham.
Miss Harris and I will be talking about the importance of cultural pride today.
So that's why you got that new do.
Yeah, girl, I'm rocking my fro. I'm bringing the 60s back. So, let's get it. The song that was playing was by James Brown, the godfather of soul, and it's titled, Say It Loud, I'm Black and I'm Proud. Brown recorded this live with a group of children from the Los Angeles area.
When did James Brown write that song?
He wrote it 53 years ago, and it was released in August 1968, just 4 months after the assassination of Martin Luther King.
That must have been a tough time. Do you want to explain to the children why he wrote it?
Absolutely. Brown witnessed fighting among blacks in Los Angeles, and he thought to himself, we've lost our pride. So he went to his hotel room, and he wrote the lyrics to the song on a napkin.
He must have really been upset.
Oh, yes, he was, and so was I. It was the 60s, and it was a very difficult time in our country. Many black Americans were losing hope and needed this uplifting message, one that promoted self-worth. This song was just one example.
So in this song, Brown sings about his pride and who he is, and he speaks about his culture as something to celebrate. It makes me feel proud to be black.
Yes, me too. This song was one of celebration. It made us feel good about who we were. I remember. It was the first time I felt a sense of pride in being black. Because up until this time, if someone called you black, you were insulted because it had a negative meaning. It was almost like someone calling you a bad word.
So the song helped to give black people a sense of pride in themselves. What other messages promoted black pride at that time?
Well, we were saying things like black is beautiful and I am somebody. But I wasn't just saying these things. I was actually feeling them. It was the first time in my life that I began to take pride in who I was. What I began to understand was that black wasn't a color, but a culture. We are a race of people who have contributed to this great nation of ours just like every other culture.
So, is that when you became interested in teaching children about the black culture?
Yes, I wanted them to have pride in who they were. But not just the black culture. I wanted my children to know more about all cultures that are a part of this great melting pot.
Do you want to explain why we should want to learn about other cultures?
Honestly, we should all want to learn more about other cultures and about our own culture too. It makes us better able to empathize with others. We are able to accept each other and respect and embrace our differences.
It also helps us to recognize how we have many things in common with other cultures.
You are so right, Ms. Harris.
So I guess the message for today is that if we all learn about our cultures as well as other cultures, the world would be a better place for all of us.
Absolutely. The other message is one of encouragement. I think we should encourage everyone in our Red Bank family to learn as much as they can about their culture and embrace those from other cultures. Well, Tiffany, thank you so much for being my special guest today.
Miss Graham, I so agree.
Coming from RB Soul, we'll see you next time. And don't forget to walk in your greatness every day. See you soon. Peace.
In my hand. Get all the way goddamn.